A vertical stretch or compression. Well, a vertical stretch is actually a non-rigid transformation of a graph. It changes the shape. So if we call it a stretch, it makes the graph look more narrow. So it's not rigid like a vertical shift was, where it preserved the shape. It actually changes the shape. And a compression is also a change in the shape, and it actually compresses the graph in the vertical direction. So you actually see the shape become wider. It changes the shape of the parent graph. So if we have an equation, y equals c times f of x, in other words, the c's outside the grouping symbols. It's not operating on the x, it's operating on the outside of the function. So multiplying c on the outside, then the action we take is only to the y values. This only changes what's happening to y when we see a number on the outside of f of x. So we multiply the y values by c. Now what's important is the vertical stretch or compression, we only look at c as a positive number. Now c also has a further separation, and that's how we know it's a stretch or a compression. We either have c strictly greater than 1, and that is a stretch by a factor of c. In other words, we multiply by a number greater than 1, we are making the y values bigger. Now we also have where c could live between 1 and 0, but not equal to 0 and not equal to 1. This is where a compression happens. Think about a number between 0 and 1. Let's think about 1/3, let's say. That means we're going to multiply the y values by 1/3, and that shrinks the y values, so it compresses the y values. So that's a compression by a factor of c. Now let's go ahead and keep looking at our parent graph, the absolute value function, and we'll see how it changes the shape of the V curve. So just getting sketched in our parent graph, y equals the absolute value of x, my x and my y-axis here. Our key points, or our anchor points I sometimes call them, are going to be negative 1, 1, 0, 0, and 1, 1. Let's go ahead and change the color to green again, I guess, first. And let's say we're going to graph this function, y equals 2 times the absolute value of x. Now notice the factor of 2 is outside the symbol for the absolute value, so it's outside of the function. And that means for every y value of those three key points, I'm just going to multiply that by 1. I'm not going to do anything to the x values. So I'd be at negative 1, 2. For the first key point. For 0, 0, if I multiply the y value of 0 times 2, I still get 0, so I haven't changed the origin here. I haven't changed the turning point of the graph. And when I go to the last key point of 1, 1, I'm just multiplying the y value of 1 times 2. So I get the point 1, 2 on the graph of y equals 2 times the absolute value of x. So you can see that the v has become more narrow. It's a stretch in the vertical direction. Let's go ahead and pick another color for the demonstration of a compression. And let's say we're going to graph y equals, let's pick a number between 0 and 1. Let's just go ahead and use 1 half. That's an easy number between 0 and 1. So now this should be a vertical compression. So the graph, the shape of the V should look more wide. It should be wider than the shape of the parent graph. So let's see what happens. Notice once again, if I multiply the origin's y value 0 times 1 half, I still get 0. So I still have 0, 0 on the compressed graph. But if I multiply the y value of the parent graph for 1, I'm going to get 1, 1 half here. Nothing happens to the x, but I get 1 half for the y. And likewise, for my key point, anchor point of negative 1, 1, negative 1, the x value stays the same, but I get 1 half for the y value. So if we sketch the shape of this transformation, you can see the blue graph. Oops, I did it again and jumped us around. So bear with me while I find the graph again. Trying to get this over there. There we go. So if you look at the blue graph of y equals 1 half, the absolute value of x, you can see that that does look wider, because the value of a c is between 0 and 1. So that's a compression in the vertical direction.